I'm Colin, and in this video, we're going to overview some different types of adhesives for paving stone projects or retaining wall so that when you have a project coming up, you know exactly which kind to use. One of the more common types of adhesives when it comes to concrete projects is going to be a caulk style. So we have a few here, a couple of them we sell, a couple of them we don't sell, but are more readily available. The first one we're going to talk about is Surebond 15. So Surebond 15 is basically a general strength but rapid setting adhesive. So if you're building a wall that requires lots of stacking and you don't want things to move and shift on you while you're assembling that, then this would be a better glue for you because it has that rapid setup time. It gets firmer quicker. It still can be applied to wet or frozen block like some other concrete adhesives and has a very good strength and longevity when it comes to holding step treads or capstones on your project. The second one is Surebond 20. This is the most commonly sold by us because it's a flexible adhesive. So if you're in a market or an area with freeze-thaw and you have some expanding with that moisture that can get trapped in between your paving stones or capstones, this flexible adhesive will move with that and not become separated. Therefore, you have a little bit more length and longevity and performance out of that. Still works on wet or frozen block, but it does have a little bit more setup time than your SB-15. So it works really well, but it can take a little bit longer to firm up. So if you're stacking a very tall wall with lots of smaller blocks, it may take a little bit longer for you to keep things straight and from sliding. And the third is basically the most readily available probably across the US, and that's Loctite's PL Premium. This is really a general adhesive in the construction world, but a lot of hardscape guys do like to use it for concrete products, whether it's step treads, paving stones, or retaining walls. It works really, really well. It's got really good strength, but it has no flexibility and probably the longest setup time out of these three adhesives. That being said, if it's the only adhesive that you can locate near you, it is a great performing one, but again, that longer setup time and no flexibility may be an issue in your area. If it is, you can look into the 20 for that flexibility, or if you want something quick, you can get the SB-15 for your rapid set. Regardless of which one you choose, the orientation of how you apply that glue is probably the most important, not only to its performance of the glue itself, but the performance of your retaining wall or your paving stones. And the reason why is if you do beads of these glues in a parallel fashion across the top of your wall, you can actually trap moisture in there, making freeze-thaw, popping caps, and separating walls. It also will trap lime in your block and make lime runs off the face wherever it can find an artery or a place for it to run out, and that doesn't look aesthetically pleasing. So when you're using these three types of caulks, make sure you do dime-sized dollops alternating throughout your blocks or perpendicular lines far away from the face of that block to keep it from going out to the front. One sort of niche type of adhesive in the hardscape world is Pavetech's SuperWet. So for us here in the Willamette Valley and all the contractors that we service, they do a lot of projects in the winter time when everything is sopping wet. And this specific adhesive actually only really works when the product itself is wet. So if you're doing wall caps, step stones, or something along those lines and your materials are all soaking wet, you'll want to use this product. It's semi-flexible and also partially expanding. The orientation is a little bit different for this glue. Instead of doing perpendicular lines or dime-sized dollops, you're gonna do an S shape with it and kind of cover the block side to side with that, and you'll get great performance out of it when it's sopping wet. A newer style of adhesive in the hardscape market is going to be a spray foam type of adhesive. Here specifically, we have SRW Products SF8, which is semi-new. The cool things about a spray foam adhesive versus a caulk style is you get an absurd amount more per can of lineal feet of coverage than you would in a caulk tube. So that means less time changing your caulk tubes, more time gluing with these larger cans. Another thing is the incredibly fast setup time. So if you're building a wall with smaller wall units and you need that adhesive to set up quicker so you can keep things flat and level, this is going to help you with that 8-minute setup time versus the SB-15's 15 minute. So it is much faster. It's also semi-expanding, which helps if there's any small gaps or voids in your wall block or caps. It fills that void, creating contact and adhering much better. It's also semi-flexible, so you still get some performance in those freeze-thaw climates, and it is also a very fast and easy to use glue. You want to make sure that when you're using this glue that you do dime-sized dollops or perpendicular lines just like you would with those caulk styles, and to keep it from coming out of the face of that block. So when you have an upcoming hardscape project and you're perusing through your hardware store looking for the right type of adhesive, Try not to reach for tub and tile caulks or general construction adhesives because they may not be built for the weather or the purpose of utilizing concrete products and bonding them together, especially when you've seen all these examples of the proper types of adhesives to use. If you want to learn more projects you can do by yourself in your backyard, side yard, or front yard, check out our website, westerninterlock.com, or see some inspiring videos on our YouTube channel, Western Interlock.